Okay, sports fans. We had an interesting thing happen yesterday with a Honda. I believe the acid test for a Honda on the final road test to see if it's going to go out and live is to measure the cooler flow. And right now, I'm of the opinion that it needs to have at least 9 tenths of a gallon of flow. 9 tenths of a gallon per minute flow when it's hot in lockup at a freeway cruise. Otherwise, it's going to come back burned up. That's just the bottom line. There's a lot of different causes, a lot of contributing factors, basically internal leaks. The pump is minimal volume. What Honda did, they made that pump just barely enough volume to where it would not be a parasitic drag and reduce the miles per gallon, the fuel economy, where they could get the maximum fuel economy, reduce emissions. And they did that in an effort to do that. The side effect was, once time and mileage took its toll and the internal leaks built up, especially at low pump speed and an idle, the cooler flow would just drop, and it would be like 3 or 4 tenths of a gallon per minute hot sitting still. And this the converter guys got all blamed for it. I mean, the Honda converters, like in the Odyssey and stuff, and the Accords, like B7 WA and those units, BAXA, all of those units, the converters were just dying left and right. And even Transtar, for a bit, they were quarantining the Odyssey converters, the Honda converters. And the poor converter guys were getting beat up, and it's not a converter issue. Now, granted, you could do things wrong building the converter, and the converter will fail. But by and large, it's a problem in inside the transmission and or cooler system to where it does not flow enough oil in and out of the converter. Now, Maura Stafford at Sonax came up with a great idea on that PR valve. She's got a patent on that thing. To where when the PR valve closes, the check ball and spring inside that PR valve still allows flow. But heck, still, what we've seen and what you'll see in another video is still when you come to stop, the pump speed, that skinny pump, those thin pump gears still cannot pump enough fluid hot at low speed. Even if you do everything you can to stop the internal leaks, you put all new shaft bushings in it, you put all the Sonax end plugs in it, put all three valves in the PR valve body. You could ream the PR valve bore, put that in, the lockup valves, and just do every Sonax update known to man inside that thing. And make sure the cooler flows really well. You can put an external cooler on it for all that matters. The problem is lack of flow through the, in and out of the cooler, in and out of the converter specifically. And but that poor pump, my opinion, my professional opinion is if Sonax or somebody could make pump gears just a little bit thicker, higher volume, say, and don't overdo it, just maybe 100 thousandths thicker to where we in the field could machine that valve body, that pump pocket, machine it 100 thousandths deeper and put that in there. That way at low pump RPM, it will, pump more volume. But we don't want to overdo it because that small diameter of the PR valve, we don't want to have that pump put out so much volume that it overruns the exhaust capacity of that skinny PR valve. And but I, in my opinion, that's the answer. That's the answer, to come up with aftermarket pump gears that are just a skosh thicker. And I'll leave that up to the engineering department on what they think of that thought. And if they think that's amenable on how much thicker to make it. But it's going to be a tightrope on how much thicker to make it. And but I think it's something that's worth looking at. But that's my opinion. And I'm Larry Bloodworth, Certified Transmissions, Draper, Utah. Thanks.